I'm waiting for the moon to come up over the river over there, and we'll see if I can get lucky. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. It's always an adventure. Well, whether the moon comes up like I predict it will or not, this thing sure is a pretty place to sit around and kill a little bit of time in the evening. This again is the South Fork near my home, about 15 miles away. It's nice having this little gym here. I'm right atop a 30-foot waterfall, but you can't see it from here. But, you know, I can't include it in the photo because then I'll miss the moon. But we've all seen that one before. Well, the dang moon decided to come up a couple of miles, two or three or four or 5 miles too far south from the river where I wanted it, right over there. The dang moon never listens to me. Nor the stars, nor my wife. Nor my kids. Well, sitting by that stream got me thinking about fishing. Looking at that river down below that I used to be a guide on made me think about fishing more and made me reminisce about a lot of the fish I caught and the people I met and the great times I had out there. That was another incredible job, another little fun little portion of my life, and that started making me feel better after the moon kind of going, you know, coming up 5 miles too far to the south, you know, for what I wanted. Then I started to think that, yeah, we could get some good sunsets, you know, I might be able to make something out of that moonshot even though it's the wrong place. We'll see what happens when I get this home stuff at home on my computer. Well, the moon largely failed me, but a kick-ass sunset saved the day. So, pretty happy with all that. Anyway, nice little evening. Not too far from home. Yeah, the sunset was away from the direction of the rising moon. And in the wrong direction. I should have brought my 16 to 35 millimeter, but you know, the right lens is always at home, but I think I still did okay. But you know, that's the way it is. You know, you try to pack light, you know, or you plan poorly. I didn't think I was going to need a wide angle lens. I planned to be in a different spot. Oh well, you know, next time. Adios. Well, I guess I got some explaining to do. Photographer's psychology makes us go into a shoot, you know, expecting the worst, but hoping for the best. And so we go in there and we wait and we hope and we talk to the sky and we talk to the rivers and we talk to the moon, hoping for the best. And this way we can be prepared to pay for the gasoline to make it to the failures so that we can again later make it to the successes.